Clearly, as a university, we would like to reward excellence. Excellence in education, and you're in a way a result of that program as you have it, but also excellence in research. And we have at the end stage of the bachelor program, a bachelor end project, which is a research project. And in a master phase, there's almost a full year that you dedicate to research. And the result of that then is a thesis. And the theses have all been evaluated, been graded. And out of all the theses that we've had, in each program that we had, you were nominated to be a candidate for the final award that we have today. That in itself, I think, is already a major achievement. I hope you realize that. As a university, we have about between 1,000 and 1,500 graduates each year. So you're really looking at the best of the best. The top 1%, or even less than that, of our university. So you can be really proud of yourself. And I hope that the family and friends feel that as well. The situation today is a bit different from normally. Normally, we would have this event as part of the momentum as we have it. Clearly, today we can't have it that way because of the COVID-19 crisis. And you just have to look at this audience. This is a corona-proof setting, which also shows the kind of challenges that we have today in our education program. Normally, we could easily fit 500 people in this room. Today, it's about 50 or that order of magnitude. And that's what we have across the university. The capacity is about 25-30% of normal. But we're really proud of what we have here today. We're proud of you. It's a very special situation that we can honor you and give you the spotlight. The ultimate winner is not known yet to you. I just said it. I know who's the winner, but you don't know it yet. So it's a bit of a surprise, and I'm looking forward to how it goes. This year, we've asked each of you to present a pitch, and we've recorded it. It's a 30-second pitch. Hope you're going to like it, because you're going to look at yourself. It's always difficult. But we've also put it on the web, and we've asked the audience to vote. We've actually had more than 3,000 votes. It's interesting. So a lot of people have actually looked at your pitch, and they voted, and later on we'll make known who that who the audience award received. So today we're having two awards that we'll present. It's the Bachelor of Science Award, and there is the Master of Science Award. I will start off with the Bachelor of Science Award. The procedure of today, I can't shake hands, and I can't even hand out anything to you, because we have to take this 1.5 meter distance. You'll find two crosses on stage. That's your cross. This is mine. So when I name the name, and the suggestion is that you walk on stage. While you walk on stage, we will show the pitch that you have created. You will get a certificate. You take your position at the cross, and then the picture will be taken. And so that's the way we'll proceed with everything. Okay? The winners of the award, I have a laudatio that takes a bit more time. Hope you appreciate that. So at least one of you will be here twice. Yeah? I suggest that we now start with the Bachelor of Science Award. And the winner is Hinok Abadi. Please come on stage.
Locally resonant acoustic mechanism for your family, very special certificate, to get attenuated waves, extra frequency ranges. In my thesis, I investigated the applicability of simplifications from 3D to 2D modeling to reduce numerical analysis costs. I concluded that the dimensionality reduction approach is reasonable whenever the panel width to length ratio is over 10. With this knowledge, simulations can be done faster and will get closer to a future with less noise pollution in a sustainable way.
Maybe I can help you. You take this, take the picture, take this with you, and then you, when you go off stage, you get the check. Yeah? This is for the picture. But I have a laudatio to as well, because your supervisors wrote down what they felt about your thesis work. So it's important, I think, that you take good note of this. During his work on the project, Hinok has shown an outstanding scientific attitude, above the one expected by a Bachelor of Science student. He has shown a remarkable ability to master novel subjects in an in-depth manner. In a short time, and subsequently independently, drove this project while discussing his ideas with the supervisors. They considered it a real pleasure to work with you and on this project. So they congratulate you, they say we congratulate you, but it means that they congratulate you with this award, and we wish him a lot of success with his current master's study and future career, and hope to see you again on stage in about 2 years' time when you have your master's studies. Congratulations. Yeah. Okay. You can take the check with you. Does it work for you? Yeah. There's a lot to you have to take with you. Sorry. Then we move to the Master of Science Thesis Awards. This group, you're at the end stage of your program. We do this every year, a master thesis program. So it's the best master thesis that we have within the university. And each of the programs that we've had could put forward what they consider to be the best master thesis within that specific program. And out of those, you have been selected by the jury. So I think in itself, you are a winner today. Within the program, you were considered to be the best. Again, the procedure as we have it, I will call your name, gradually walk onto stage. At the same time, we will show the pitch, take a picture, and then I ask you to go back again. And at the end, I will announce the winner. Okay? So one of you will be on stage twice. And I wonder who that will be. The first nominee is Sander Akkermans.
Future society. But imagine crossing the road in front of it without a human driver to make eye contact with. How would you know whether these cars intend to yield for you? And would you trust their technology enough to cross the road in front of them? I conducted a virtual reality experiment answering exactly these questions. And with my results, I argue for a design that is adapted to human behavior instead of the other way around, making them as safe, pleasant as possible for all road users involved.
Thank you. Congratulations. The second is Melissa Bevers from Biomedical Engineering.
Did you know that up to 30% of all scaphoid fractures is missed at initial presentation? Consequently, treatment of these common fractures in your hands can have serious long-term complications, leading to pain and limited functionality in your wrist. Therefore, during my graduation project, we explored the feasibility of a new high-resolution CT technique, HRPQ-CT. Which we hope in future may contribute to an improved diagnosis. You also wouldn't want to experience long-term complications due to delayed diagnosis, would you?
No. And then from Applied Physics, Rick Budet.
Wind and solar power upgrade. What happens in a day when there is no sun and no wind? In the future, the answer might be nuclear fusion. This will provide humanity with a clean and reliable source of power for centuries or millennia to come. During my master's project, I've been working on a modeling method that can quickly and accurately describe the behavior of one of the most commonly employed heating methods in fusion reactors. This could eventually lead to design improvements or plasma optimizations.
Right. Congratulations. From mechanical engineering, we have Koen Klaasens. Koen.
Imagine that you are printing 3D products for the high-tech industry. Then you do not only want to print parts that are very precise and of high resolution, but you also want your parts to have good material properties. And to do so in a consistent manner has proven to be very difficult. We propose a paradigm where we exploit the knowledge that we have about the printing process at microscale to enhance the control strategy. And that will allow to significantly improve the repeatability, the consistency, and the end product quality of 3D printed parts.
Yeah, right. Congratulations. Thank you. From the built environment, Alex Donkers.
climate change is the biggest challenge of our next decades, and vehicles contribute a lot to it. I created a model which could predict the energy consumption of electric vehicles and found which factors influence the energy consumption the most. It's a fundamental step towards sustainable driving strategies and could be used by engineers, policymakers, and by you to drive more efficient tomorrow.
Right. It's scary to look at yourself, isn't it? I mean, now from electrical engineering, Iris Huyben.
Quicker and more accurate scans improve the diagnostics in the hospital. However, these accurate scans come with great amounts of data that we can hardly process or store anymore. So our self-learning software reduces the data with an amount that we thought was never possible before, while still creating accurate scans. We applied this software for medical ultrasound imaging. It now allows for accurate scans inside the heart, where it's difficult to acquire data. And also we realized that this software can be used to reduce the acquisition time of an MRI or even diminish the amount of harmful radiation for a patient in a CT scan.
Right, thank you. Okay. From industrial design, Daan Matthijssen.
System helps 6 to 10 year old children overcome their bedwetting problems. This affects about 12% of all 6 to 10 year olds, which equals more than 80 million children worldwide. Within 6 to 12 weeks of using the Dry Nights bedwetting system, these children will be conditioned to wake up on their own and use the toilet before wetting the bed, saving families hundreds of euros on diapers and medication each year, and it helps the child to gain continence and self-confidence. The self-powered sensor also saves millions of batteries each year and is also safer since it uses sound instead of Bluetooth to communicate with the mobile app.
Right. From the Chemical Engineering and Chemistry Department, Romy Porter.
Advancing optimizing industries is essential. Therefore, I focused on optimizing the peroxyester industry. Without these peroxyesters, it wouldn't be possible to produce, for example, the shoes that you're wearing, the doors and windows that we use every day, or a wide range of medical devices. Within my research, promising results were obtained both experimentally and numerically, which could really help the industry becoming more productive. Because in the end, don't we all want to live in a cleaner, safer, and more energy-efficient world?
From industrial engineering, Nikki Teres.
For ambulance services, an improvement in the on-time performance can literally save lives. Unfortunately, while in our aging society, demand for ambulance services keeps growing, resources like personnel are getting more and more scarce. In my thesis, I significantly improved the on-time performance without the need for additional resources. I did this by proposing a smarter way to decide which ambulance to send to which incident, using machine learning and simulations. My research contributes towards making emergency healthcare future-proof.
Great. And the last one on this list is from computer science, Hilde Weerts.
Artificial intelligence is increasingly used in all different kinds of applications. However, it can be quite difficult to understand the inner workings of these models. And this makes it difficult to judge the trustworthiness of a prediction. During my thesis project, I've developed a new visualization approach that allows human analysts to better understand the trustworthiness of a prediction based on previous similar cases. So if you believe it's important that artificial intelligence is trustworthy, please vote for me.
Great. If you want to have a second look at these pictures, they can be found on the website that we have. And like I said before, at least 3,000 people have taken note of it. So interesting to see it. So now we are getting to the winner of the Master of Science Award. And that's exciting, I hope, for you. So I'll take a bit more time. No, I'll just announce it. Iris Huyben. No, you can take the flowers and because I have a laudatio for you as well. So this is the evaluation of the jury. The thesis introduces deep probabilistic subsampling for task adaptive compressed sensing to optimize the task for process of a system involving subtasks of processes. I hope you still understand what I'm talking about. It's a complicated subject. The framework is widely applicable and thus can have broader impact. The thesis is well structured and written in a form of a scientific article. Interestingly, the topic is presented in a very accessible and compelling way. The study combines a newly developed scientific method with results of high societal impact with multiple relevant applications in image processing, for example, ultrasound imaging and MRI. The work has already led to a number of publications, with Iris Huiber as first or even single author, and an invited lecture. That's quite an achievement in the master phase. Congratulations with this report. Yeah? Thank you. Congratulations, Iris. I hope you enjoy it. There's quite a few things that you need to take with you, but you can wait if you want after this ceremony. Yeah? Yeah, that brings me to the end of this award session. I hope you have enjoyed it. We really wanted to give the spotlight to the most talented people that we have at this university. I hope you're not disappointed by the fact you didn't win, because you did win. Being nominated in itself, I think, is a big win. Within the program, it is really an outstanding achievement. And actually, I feel it as a privilege that you are at this university. I feel it as a privilege that we can work with you, that we can teach you, that we do research with you. It's really fascinating to see how you can grow in the period that you are at this university. And at the end stage, you'll have the kind of wonderful results that you have today. So I'm really privileged that you're here. Hope you enjoy the afternoon, and hope you enjoy this situation as well. Thank you for being here, and looking forward to see you somewhere in the future. Hopefully some of you as PhD students. A very warm welcome to this session, in which we honor the PDN program and the nominees that we have, and you can see them here in front of the lecture hall. Really exciting. So we're now in the Atlas building, in one of the largest lecture halls that we have. And if you look around, you can see the issue that we have today at the university because of the corona crisis. The number of people that we can have in the lecture hall is really limited to basically a few. And if you walk along the campus, you will see still a few students, but not nearly as many as we normally have. So normally you will see thousands of students walking around at this university today. It's really, unfortunately, very limited. We really would like to get back to the normal situation as soon as we can, but it may take a while before we're at that situation. But today, we celebrate your achievement, nevertheless, because we think it's very important that we celebrate that. And I'm really glad that we can have this today with you. A special welcome also to the jury members that have made this selection, the supervisors that were involved in your work, and hopefully also family and friends, and also for those who are sitting at home watching this live stream. Welcome to this event. As a university, we clearly value excellence in teaching as well as in research. And you're an example thereof, because you really delivered an outstanding result with your thesis. Normally, we would have this event as part of Momentum, which is a big event where we celebrate the graduation of all our bachelor students and master students. Clearly, today we cannot have that in a normal setting. There is a special session later this afternoon, which is completely online, completely organized by the students. So I'm kind of excited to see what's going to happen. I haven't seen it myself yet, so I hope you find some time to have a look at that as well. The awards that we have are for the bachelor's, for the master, for the PDN. That's what we have here today. And later on today, we also have the PhD award. And you have been selected out of your program. So if you look at the PDENC program, each year we have about 100 graduates. So it's really special that you're sitting here. All these people think that you have delivered within your program the best possible result this year. And one of you will win that award today. And one has already won an award, and we'll come back to that later on. Because the you were asked, each of you were asked to prepare a 30-second pitch. You will have a look at that later on. You may have seen it already on the website. It's always scary to look at yourself. At least I find it always scary to look at myself. I don't know what you thought of it. But I think it's nice that we actually put you in the spotlight. You really deserve it, I think. And that's why we're also going to put you in the spotlight here. There was also a this also created an opportunity, these pitches, because we put them on the website. And the audience could look at them. And we've had more than 3,000 views of these pitches. So your pitch has been looked at quite a number of times, most likely. And so there was a voting, and there was a clear winner, and I will give that later today. But I think it's important that we give you the attention that you deserve, because you really delivered a very special result, and you can be really proud of that. We are proud of you. I hope that your family and friends are proud of you. And it's really a privilege to work with such talented individuals. It's really incredible to see what the people at this university, whether they're students, whether they're PhDing, or whether they're PhD candidates, can deliver in terms of science and applications that we have. So it's really, I consider it an honor to work with you. So the ceremony itself, so you each of you will get a certificate, and we have to strictly stick with the Corona rules. So I cannot be within 1.5 meters from you. I cannot congratulate you. I would really love to congratulate you by shaking your hands, but clearly we can't do that. We're going to ask you to come forward, and there's a cross that's yours. There's another cross that's mine, and then you walk towards your cross. Then we will look at your pitch, and then we will take a picture of you. Okay? And then we give you a big hand. The sequence that we have is first from clinical informatics, Lars van der A. We will give a big hand. We have
my name is Lars, and as a clinical informatics, I experience the value of healthcare data. Data to help healthcare professionals to improve the quality of care. The biggest challenge is how to convert data into information, especially when 80% of the data is in free text form. Unstructured data. Text mining algorithms can help to explore these free texts and transform it into valuable information. The lessons learned based on the case study and the qualitative research have been translated into a step-by-step plan and is available for you. So don't reinvent, get it right now, and contribute to data-driven healthcare. Mail for more information to l.vda@cgt.nl.
Right, yeah. Maybe you could pick up your certificate, and then we can put it on the picture. I think it looks at least a lot better. And you deserve it. Okay, thank you. Thank you very much. So I suggest when you walk up to your cross, you pick up the certificate. And from data science, the nominee is Joep van der Boogaard. But Joep could not make it. So I have someone that I've seen already. That I was a bit confused. How can you get a master thesis and a PhD thesis at the same time? But Hilde Weerts is replacing Joep today. But we'll get to see you.
Firefighters provide aid in a range of situations. Of course, when there's a fire, but also when, for example, a severe car accident happens or when someone needs CPR. In these moments, every second counts. In my PDM project, I developed intelligent software for the fire department. Through simulations, predictions, and artificial intelligence, I enable them to make data-driven decisions to ensure quick responses to incidents. So, if you want to be rescued quickly when your house is on fire, then vote for me.
Great. Next, from the Qualified Medical Engineering program, Sophie Kramer. And I will explain later why she has flowers.
Hier op de neonatologie doen we ons uiterste best om vroeggeboren baby's zo goed mogelijk te ondersteunen tijdens de eerste weken of maanden van hun leven. Vanwege de onvergroeide hersenen vergeten deze baby's vaak om te ademen, wat kan leiden tot levenslange schade aan hun ogen, longen en hersenen. Ik probeer de ademhaling te stimuleren door te aaien of te draaien. Maar dan kan ik niet de hele dag naast de confuse staan om direct te reageren. Daarom hebben wij Breathe Buddy ontwikkeld. Een systeem dat automatisch stimuleert, precies wanneer dat nodig is. Daarmee helpt Breathe Buddy ons om de zorg die wij geven nog verder te verbeteren. En dat heeft weer een positief effect op de rest van het leven van onze kleine patiëntjes.
Maar heel mooi. Dank je wel. Thank you. Yeah. From Smart Buildings and Cities, Anne Graven.
Do you know somebody with dementia? This is highly likely. Only in the Netherlands there are already 280,000 people diagnosed. It puts much pressure on the Dutch healthcare system and has negative financial and societal consequences. But most importantly, it has a big impact on the lives of people with dementia and their families. For those people to remain living in their own homes can make a big difference. That's why I'm developing the Guardian Environment, a smart home system that can support and stimulate good daily activities using smart projections, light and sound signals, and can adapt to the user's needs. With the Guardian Environment, we can help people with dementia live longer independently in their own homes.
Congratulations. From the Automotive Systems Design Program, we have Siddharth Galati.
If babies are born early or premature, then there is a high chance that they can become blind due to a retinal detachment condition called retinopathy of prematurity, or ROP. Each year, over 15 million babies are born premature globally, and hence, ROP is one of the leading causes of childhood blindness. Unfortunately, a majority of these babies are born in developing countries where the premature care is rather poor, and hence, a vast number of ROP patients do not get treated. The overall goal of this project is to eradicate childhood blindness due to ROP globally by developing a machine that is autonomous, accurate, and which needs less time to treat ROP. Thank you.
Thank you. From the Software Technology Program is Annie Begert-Dumian. I hope I pronounced it correctly.
Hello, I'm Annie Begert-Dumian, PDN in Software Technology. Have you ever thought about how any complex domain like ASMLs can decrease costs by using artificial intelligence? Well, my designed and implemented software is out to save ASML 30,000 hours of preparing and reading machine diagnostics data. It is unique in the sense that it results in a directly applicable tool chain as proof of how artificial intelligence-infused software can assist a complex high-tech domain.
Yeah, right. Congratulations. And the last nominee of today is Edwin Schoen-Mui from the Design of Electrical Systems program.
Hello everyone, my name is Edwin Mui. I designed the F-Vision virtual reality headset for my PDN project. The F-Vision aims to completely immerse patients in a relaxing and comfortable virtual environment. We envision to help both physicians and patients to get the medical procedures right the very first time. And thereby in doing so, patients can save on costs while hospital facilities could then be freed up to treat more patients? If you do believe that this project's vision could become a reality, then please vote for me at the TUE Academy Awards. Thank you for listening, and have a great day.
Thank you. Congratulations.
Maybe you could have seen from the pictures that all these nominees have provided us, is how well this program is connected to the outside world. Specific for the PDN program, is that part of the work that they do is together with one of the companies or hospitals outside of the university. That's very specific, I think, for this program. And you could see that in the pitches that you just heard. But I'm keeping you in suspense, I think, because we're now getting to announcing the winner. And the winner of this year is Siddharth Galati. So I'll read you a short an extract of the jury report, because they looked at all these theses very carefully, and this is the rationale that they have behind it. So you were really stood out, I think, of all these nominations, because you were number one to all the jury members. So it's really special. The project tackles a significant real challenge in the field of multidimensional disciplinary complexity with excellent social and technical impact. The project supervisors clearly state that the design objective was met and exceeded, and are highly positive in their praise for all aspects of the project. The thesis clearly motivates and describes the problem, including its societal impact. Mr. Galati delivered a concrete device, which clearly can be put into practical use, as the supervisors clearly attest. This important aspect gives the work special distinction. Congratulations. Beautiful words, I think, from the jury. Yep. Congratulations, and I wish you best of luck with your future career. Yeah, thank you very much. Big hand again. Now, there's a special award that we are handing out today as well in this session. As I already explained to you, all these pitches were put on the website and people could vote. The audience award, and someone has won it, and that person has already flowers, and I would like Sophia to come forward. Congratulations. Yeah. Yeah, I think it's really special that you have this audience award. Congratulations again. Yeah. That brings me to the end of this award session. I hope you enjoyed it. I think they deserve the attention. It's really special that you can come at this stage. And like I said before, it was really a privilege to work with you. And we are honored that you take this degree from our university. And I wish you a lot of success in your future career. I think many of you already found something. I hope you enjoy it. And hope to see you again at this university soon as an alumnus of the university. Thank you again. Hope to see you soon again. Goodbye. So, good afternoon. And a very warm welcome to the Blauwe Zaal of our university. A special welcome also to all of those who have been involved in the supervision and working with these outstanding PhDs, candidates. Well, not anymore candidate, you have your PhD already. Must have been a pleasure to work with you. Also to family and friends, a warm welcome to this special session. Also those who are looking at it from home, because we unfortunately, under the current circumstances, we cannot host a lot of people in this hall. Usually we have about 500 people in this lecture hall, and today I think it's 50 at most. Which also shows you a bit of the challenge that we have as a university today, how to have physical presence of people. But today we are here to look at the nominations of really outstanding PhDs. the best of the best, you could say. We have about 300 graduations each year, and so being nominated within your own program in itself, I think, is an enormous achievement. So at the end of the day, you're winners by definition. I'm going to hand out the award to one of you, but I hope you really appreciate that what you have done is really, really very special within your own program. Now, we clearly, as a university, value excellence in education as well as in research. And today it's all about the research that we have. And you really, I don't know, I would have loved to work with you. I've had the privilege to work with quite a few PhD students, and it's always a thrill to work with highly talented people. They can really do something, push the frontiers of science, push the frontiers of technology, and something new is happening, something that you didn't really think of when you thought about when you started the project. And I find that always exceptionally fascinating to see what sort of new things you could do. And you are, I think, the perfect examples of that. We've had sessions for the best bachelor thesis, the best master thesis, the best PDENC thesis, but this is, I think, at the top of the rank, the best PhD thesis. You've been through this program, the bachelor program, the master program, and another, well, usually 4 years, sometimes a bit more, sometimes a bit less, to get your PhD degree. This year, we've had to approach things a little bit different because of the corona situation, but something innovative emerged out of it, because we've asked you all to develop a 30-second pitch in which you try to describe what the work was about that you've done the last four-something years. I'm looking forward to these pitches. We've actually put all these pitches on the website, and 3,000 people actually looked at them, voted. So maybe even more people have looked at them, but 3,000 people voted. And the audience award has been handed out already in a previous session, so it's not one of you, but I guess you knew that already. But nevertheless, I think it's really interesting to see that so many people are interested in what you do. It's not just your family, but otherwise, I guess the number of people that would have looked at it would be about, I don't know, 10, 20, that order of magnitude, but 3,000. So people have really looked at it and tried to get an opinion of it. I really like that idea, and I hope that we can continue that in the future. Now we're going to the award itself. What we're going to do is to ask you, each of you, and I will name him. When I name your name, you come forward, you pick up the certificate, and there are two crosses on stage. One is mine, and the other is yours. So you take your position, and then we play your pitch, and then you return to your seat. Is that okay with you? That's the way we'll do it. And I will name you one by one. So the first is from the mechanical engineering program, Thomas Irons. Thomas.
Fluctuating environment conditions can cause damage to wooden objects. To preserve their collection, museums tend to strictly limit relative humidity fluctuations, which leads to a massive energy consumption and a large environmental footprint. During my PhD, I have conducted several experimental studies to determine which fluctuations are safe and which are potentially harmful. This research thus contributes to the preservation of our cultural heritage and to reducing the environmental footprint of museums.
Yeah, that's you. Oh, wait. I'm going to take a picture of you. Just a second. It's very important that you have a picture. Yeah? Okay. Thank you again. So don't forget, they will take a picture of you. From the biomedical engineering program, Emil van Disseldorp.
I'm Emil, and in my PhD, I developed a computational model which helped clinicians to decide when aortic surgery is required. The dilated aorta, known as aneurysm, is imaged with 3D ultrasound to capture the complete geometry and movement of the aortic wall. Using this data, we create a patient-specific computer model and provide, besides the maximum diameter, also local stiffness and wall stress to the clinician. These additional measures help to identify patients at risk. Thank you.
Yep, congratulations. From industrial design, Pauline van Dongen.
Those of you who, like me, envision more sustainable futures will at some point need to reconsider their relationship with clothing. As a design researcher specialized in wearable technologies, I've critically looked at how clothing shapes human behavior and perception. With my work, I've shown that technologies cannot simply be understood as something purely functional or aesthetic. And I hope to inspire other designers to look at the soft and embodied subjective qualities of technologies so that we can develop new, valuable human garment relationships.
Yeah, congratulations. Next, we have from the Chemical Engineering and Chemistry Department, Alessandro Janeiro.
Imagine if you control an algorithm to automatically assemble and form nanometric objects with predetermined shapes and sizes. Imagine if we could program those objects to perform complex tasks, such as encapsulating, transporting, and releasing drugs on demand. Such amazing materials already exist, but there is still a lot we don't know about them. My PhD thesis sheds new light on the behavior of these self-building systems and how to use them efficiently for real-life applications.
Congratulations. And from the Mathematics and Computer Science Department, we have Shandor Kishvaludi-Bok.
The topic of my thesis are geometric network problems, such as finding the maximum set of disjoint objects among some objects in space. And we study algorithms and lower bounds for such fundamental problems. And all of these algorithms turn out to be best possible under certain complexity theoretic hypotheses.
Now, you may have noticed that the image that was on the upper right corner was not exactly the same as this face. And that's because Sander is currently staying abroad, couldn't travel to Eindhoven. So we're really happy that Henk Alkema, that you were able to pick up the certificate. Yeah? Yeah, thank you. From the Industrial Engineering and Innovation Sciences program, Gusha Pets.
My PhD project concerns LED sources, like these ones. Specifically, we investigated how we perceive the light from LEDs. You know, one of my friends once told me she doesn't switch on the light in her room for as long as there's daylight present. And this is the thing, we do prefer daylight. There's still something rather unnatural about electric lighting. LEDs are commodity products, potentially impacting millions of people around the world. Most of us, really. Understanding this impact enables us to design LEDs that, in the future, will be at least as good as daylight.
Thank you. It's scary to look at yourself, isn't it? I wonder where you took that pitch, because it hasn't rained that much. Okay. We haven't had that much rain in the Netherlands so recently, so I was wondering where it was. From Electrical Engineering, Rogier Wildeboer.
In my research, I took up the challenge of detecting prostate cancer using an ultrasound scanner. So why is this important? Well, prostate cancer hits one in every seven men, and imaging alone is mostly unreliable. Then why ultrasound? Well, ultrasound is cheaper and more practical than its alternatives, and in major parts of the world, it might be the only scanner available. That's why I'm very happy that the promising results of this study have led to further development in the clinic. I would be very grateful for your vote. My name is Rogier Wildeboer. Thank you very much.
Congratulations. And finally, from the Built Environment Program and Department, we have Rob Wolfs. Rob.
3D concrete printing can provide a means to increase the productivity and reduce the environmental impact of our construction industry. My name is Rob Wolfs, and during my PhD research, I developed numerical models and experimental methods to control the structural behavior of 3D printed concrete. I realized a large 3D printing facility and used it to study the technique from a small to very large scale. The results of my research can be used to optimize the printing process and reduce the amount of material, and thereby provide an answer for the urgent call for a more efficient and more sustainable construction of our built environment.
Congratulations. So I hope you enjoyed it. I clearly envy you, because you're still young, you can work on these challenging problems. And I thought it was fascinating. I really enjoyed my PhD program. That's, I hope you understand that. Perhaps one of the most fun parts of your whole life, perhaps even. But now we come to the announcement of the winner of the one award. But really, I hope you appreciate that we consider you all winners in itself, but only one can come to the stage and collect the award that we have. So the winner of this year's PhD award is Rogier Willeboer. Yeah, if you take perhaps the flowers and the check. Yeah, you can't have them. You only have two hands. I think it's interesting to look at and listen to the jury report, because they have really made, I think, a very nice jury report. The thesis of Rogier Willeboer is impressive, both in quality as well as quantity. With 21 journal papers in top-ranked journals, both in the engineering, but also in the medical sciences domain. It's rather unique. You've written 3 book chapters. You've received 7 international awards, including the prestigious Young Investigator Award from the European Federation of Societies in Ultrasound and Medicine in Biology. You received your PhD thesis cum laude already in 2019, but part of this academic year. And his work has an enormous potential for making an impact on both in the clinical and industrial community. Quite an achievement. Congratulations. Yeah. This brings me to the end of this session. I hope you enjoyed being in the spotlight. That's why we did it this way. I hope you liked looking at the pitches. If you want to have a second look at each of these pitches, you can find them on the internet. Like I said, many people have already taken note of it, and it will be there for quite a while, whether you like it or not. Everything else, I hope you enjoy the afternoon. There's still room to congratulate each other and to share it with your family and friends. And again, thank you for being here. Congratulations. Hope to see you soon again.